Hi, all you healthy humans. Welcome to New Leaf Table TV. I'm your host, Chef E. Today we're making chicken coconut curry over cauliflower rice. It's gonna be super tasty. I love it. I hope you love it too. We have our shredded chicken, cauliflower rice, zucchini that's really high in vitamin C and magnesium, our sliced mushrooms. We're getting some good vitamin D as well as umami flavor for our dish. And we have our onions and turmeric that'll give us a lot of anti-inflammatory properties. And we have all of our seasonings, some full-fat coconut milk and coconut oil as well. So let's get started. Go ahead and preheat your oven to 425 degrees. Let's go ahead and get our veggies ready. We're gonna take our zucchini and we're gonna just give them a rough chop to about a half inch, quarter rounds. Go ahead and slice them up and then we'll slice them in half from here. So they'll be nice and quartered. Now we're gonna put our zucchini in our oven safe pan that's lined with unbleached parchment paper. And then we'll sprinkle it with some avocado oil, salt, and pepper. So we add our zucchini, we'll add our onions, and we'll add our mushrooms. Now add your avocado oil and salt and pepper. And then just get your hands dirty and mix it all up. All right, make sure everything is evenly coated with your salt and pepper and olive oil. And don't worry if the pan's a little crowded, it will cook down. Now let's just pop it in the preheated oven. You'll wanna leave it in the oven for about 25 minutes until the veggies are nice and tender and maybe a little brown on top. All right, while the veggies are roasting, let's make our curry sauce. So to start, take your pan, preferably something with a little bit of a higher wall so you have plenty of room for all the goodies in your dish. Turn on your stove to about medium-high heat. Take some coconut oil and about two tablespoons and just pop it right on in there. Let it get nice and melted. A little bit more. And then we'll get our garlic ready. So take 4 cloves of garlic and I'm just gonna mince them on up. You can use a garlic press or any sort of device you have to chop your garlic. This is just a little thing I got on Amazon and it is very handy. You just twist a few times and you have minced garlic. Imagine that. So pop it into the pan. I use a knife to just kind of scrape it all out of there. The aroma. I hope y'all are smelling this like I am. Garlic with coconut oil when you saute it. Oh, it smells so good. Okay, we're gonna give this a stir and let this simmer for just less than a minute. Let that garlic get nice and fragrant. And then we're gonna take about a tablespoon of our curry powder and about half a teaspoon of our turmeric and add it to the pan and let it swirl around with just the oil and the garlic. Okay, it's been 30 seconds and our turmeric and curry powder are nice and mixed in. So take your 1 can of full fat coconut milk and add it right to the pan. And take 2 tablespoons of your coconut aminos, add it on in. We'll give it a stir and we'll let all this come to a simmer. About 10 minutes through the simmer, we'll go ahead and add our coconut rice to the sauce so that it can soak up all those good juices and go ahead and cook. If you would prefer, you can absolutely cook your coconut rice separate, just in a pan, just saute it with some coconut oil. If you want to put your curry over, I just prefer to do it all in one dish. That way it's less cleanup, it's easy, and I can just scoop it into a bowl, but it's whatever you prefer. All right, we want to bring this to a nice little boil and then turn the heat down and let it simmer for about 15 minutes. While this is simmering, if you haven't already shredded your chicken, go ahead and do that. Mine is already shredded, so I don't need the time, but if you did, you can shred it. And then as you're shredding, you can add it right to the pan. That smells so good. I love the smell of curry. I'm gonna go ahead and add our cauliflower rice. You can just add about a bag of cauliflower rice. We'll let this go ahead and simmer for another 10 minutes and get nice and all cooked together. Okay, our curry has been simmering for about 15 minutes. All of its juices are soaked up in the cauliflower rice and the chicken. It's gonna be so tasty. And our veggies are ready, so let's grab them out of the oven. Okay, our veggies are ready. Our curry sauce and chicken are done. Now we're just gonna chop some fresh basil to go on top. Basil is wonderful for digestion. It's also very easy to grow. We have a plethora of basil growing in our arrow garden as well as in my windowsill at the moment. So just chop it on up and we will put it right on top of our dish. All right. Now let me show you how to assemble our curry. Take your veggies and use them as a bottom layer. Those nice green zucchinis and the onions and the mushrooms are smelling delicious. Take some of your chicken curry, put it right on top. Cauliflower rice already mixed in. If you did your cauliflower rice separately, you could just put some on the bottom. And then top with your fresh basil. And there we have our curry coconut chicken over cauliflower rice. All right, that's all we have today, folks. Thanks for watching New Leaf Table TV. Until we dine again, farewell, healthy humans. To subscribe to New Leaf Table's meal plan service with weekly meals and easy delivery through your existing Amazon Fresh membership, visit our website at newleaftable.com. And also, please hit the subscribe button to our YouTube channel. Hi, all you healthy humans. Welcome to New Leaf Table TV. I'm your host, Chef E, and today we're making, Today we're making chicken coconut curry over cauliflower rice. We have our rotisserie chicken.
Start that over again. You said rotisserie.
How do you say it?
Rotisserie.
Okay. So we have rotisserie chicken.
Rotisserie.
For our ingredients, we have rotisserie chicken. I don't know how to say it any other. We have our shredded chicken. I want to say that.
Yeah,
Rotisserie.
There's no airy.
Rotisserie. Okay. We have rotisserie. I can't say it. My brain goes blank and that's all it comes out.
I thought you were dyslexic, not.
I have rotisserie chicken. Okay. Basil is wonderful for digestion. It's also very easy to grow. We have a plethora of blah, blah, blah. That's all we have for you today, guys. Farewell, healthy humans, until we dine again. I'm Chefy. That was just not...